it's Thomas here, and today we're doing a quick review on the kilowatt PS-10 power strip. If you want to make sure you're plugging all of your reefing gear into a reliable, clean-looking, surge-protected power strip with 10 outlets and a low-profile plug, able to monitor the power consumption of your system so you know that all of your gear is working as it should, and ultimately is the same caliber as the gear you're plugging into it rather than being the weakest link of the system, then check out the Kilowatt PS-10. I'm digging that low-profile plug. Favorite kind of plug, hands down. Reef tanks tend to have a lot of equipment on them, like various pumps, skimmers, sterilizers, and lighting options that all need electricity to work, meaning lots of power cords and lots of places to plug them in. It's really important to make sure that your solution for power management is not only able to provide enough outlets for all the equipment that you need, but also that it can do it in a safe and reliable way. Not just safe for the equipment to protect it from being damaged, but also safe for your home. A rat's nest of cords plugged into a discount bin power strip or two is not a recipe for success. It's an accident waiting to happen. The Kilowatt PS-10 is a solid, reliable power strip with 10 outlets, surge protection, an adjustable circuit breaker, and a whole lot of cool tricks up its sleeve that can be useful for any reefer. The PS-10 has 10 outlets, 5 per side that face away from each other, making it easier to fit all of your plugs and power adapters without them getting cramped. It also has a 90 degree low profile plug, which I am very fond of. It makes it a lot easier to get it in behind your tank or other furniture if the outlet's covered, or simply to keep the cord from sticking out from the wall, which makes it a lot easier to hide and route neatly across your baseboards, and generally just less of an eyesore. The LCD display is backlit and easy to read and provides a real-time display of the power consumption of all the gear you have plugged into it. The 4 buttons under the display let you navigate the various readings available like voltage, wattage, or kilowatt hours. And the on and off buttons do exactly what you think they do, giving you the ability to cut power to the outlets and turn off your gear without having to unplug the power strip. Beyond its more obvious application of being energy conscious, monitoring the power consumption of your reef tank can be a great way to tell whether or not all of the equipment you have running is working as expected, or if perhaps something has failed or is in need of maintenance. If you know roughly how much wattage or power consumption your tank uses on a regular basis, a drop in that consumption could indicate a piece of equipment like a heater or pump has completely failed or is simply in need of some maintenance. Like Ryan's mentioned previously, when pumps get grimy and bog up and they stop working as efficiently, the impellers are spinning slower, and as a result, the pump actually uses less electricity to run. It's not uncommon for the pump to draw half of the expected wattage, and that would alert you that the pump is in need of some love and care. The PS-10 is going to show you the cumulative wattage of everything plugged into the strip, but if you go from 700 watts down to 680, that 20 watt loss is a pretty good indication that something's not doing exactly what it's supposed to, so you should go through all of the equipment plugged into the strip just to make sure everything's in tip-top shape. The PS-10 also has safety measures for the gear you're plugging into it, most notably the surge protection and adjustable circuit breaker. Personally, if I'm going to be plugging thousands of dollars of reefing gear into a power strip, I don't want the power strip to be the weakest link. I want to know that it's at least on par with the gear that I'm plugging into it. Otherwise, I'm just putting my gear, and by extension, my tank and inhabitants, at unnecessary risk. If a cheap power bar fails and all of the equipment plugged into it shuts off, deep trouble. The PS-10 is not the only option for power management, but it is definitely a trusted one at BRS and has been used on various tanks, including the 750XXL and the BRS160. Ryan actually has a fantastic episode on how to wire up your reef tank. You can check it out right here. Gives you lots of options and things to think about that you probably haven't considered, as well as tips on how to fix problems that you don't even know you have yet. So give it a watch. Even if your tank's already hooked up and you think you've got your wire management right, it's a good idea just to double check. There's some really good tips in there.